Hi guys, I'm Dave, and today I'm going to be telling you why the M50 Mark II is a good choice for your next camera. Let's dive in. Number one is the size. This thing is so tiny, and that's one of the main reasons why I pre-ordered this for the UK release. When I'm out and about, cycling or walking, and I've got a camera with me that only weighs 517 grams, that is exactly the main reason why I'm buying this camera. The EOS R that I'm filming on right now, it's an incredible camera. It's so good. It's amazing. Problem with it is, it weighs a kilo and a half with the lens on it. To be honest, if I'm out and about, I can't exactly fit this big camera in my pocket. So if I get the M50 Mark II with the lens on, it's still tiny. I can throw it in a jacket pocket, easily take it anywhere with me. This camera would be sticking out like a sore thumb pretty much. And I know what you're thinking, Dave, but mobile photography is like a pure thing nowadays. I hate it. I honestly hate mobile photography. See, if I'm gonna go out and take photos and video, then I want to be able to have that designated piece of gear that I'm gonna be using for photo and film in my hands so I can use it. My phone, I use that to phone people, I use it to chat to my pals, it's good for a selfie. That's it. You need your camera in your hands to actually be productive and actually do what you want to do, which is take film and take photos. I just don't like it. I don't like taking a photo with my phone. Don't like it. Done. The next reason, you've heard people talk about, what's the point in buying the M50 Mark II? It pretty much does all the same things that the M50 done with a few added extra. And this is kind of true. But the thing is, you do have a few added extras and you get a bit of a longer battery life with the M50 Mark II. And at this moment in time, the M50 is still £499 on Amazon. And the M50 Mark II, to pre-order it, is £589 at the moment. So, I mean, do you not pay a wee bit extra for extra features? Is that not why we buy better cameras? I mean, it's only 90 quid more. I mean, it's a lot of money, but in the camera world, it's not really a lot of money. And this is still an entry-level, mid-level camera. I mean, what were people expecting to have all these amazing specs for under £1,000? I don't think so. They're not gonna do that. You do have a few extra things in the M50 Mark II, and that's why it's only slightly higher. It's only £90 higher. It makes total sense. But at the same time, if you've got an M50 right now and you're like, but Dave, should I upgrade to the M50 Mark II? Then I honestly think, no, you shouldn't upgrade. Unless you do want these couple of extra, like the eye detection, for example, is meant to be really good, really quick, very handy for stuff like that. But if you've not got an M50 at the moment and you're looking to get your first camera, or maybe just an upgrade, maybe you've just got a point and shoot at the moment, I want something with interchangeable lenses, M50 Mark II is a great camera to get. And it's a reasonable price. And it does everything that you want it to do, like shoots 4K and stuff like that. You know what I mean? That's why you should maybe get that camera. If you've got the M50, does most of the same things, totally agree. But if you don't have it, and you're looking to get a camera in that kind of price range, then totally M50 Mark II, you're as well just getting that rather than M50. Because are you really wanting to get a camera and then a few months down the line, you're like, oh, I wish I had eye detection, or I wish I could get a wee bit more battery life out of it. These are the kind of things that the M50 Mark II offers. And you're also asking yourself, who is this for? Is it for me? Is it for you? Who is this camera for? And honestly, this is an entry mid-level camera. The reason I'm buying this camera, this is because I want to use it as a B camera, so like all the overhead shots and stuff like that, when I'm shooting them, I just want to be able to shoot them quite easily. I've got a good professional camera that I use for big shoots and stuff like that. If I was doing big shoots or a music video or whatever, I would be using this camera that I'm using right here. But the thing is, I want a camera that I can use as a B camera to take about with me. Shoots raw, goes between vocal lengths, perfect for what I'm looking for. But for you, I would say it's great for someone that's just starting out. Maybe they want to try a wee bit of vlogging, maybe it's photography. Do they want to do film? Do they want to just take photos? Good creator cameras. It's good for if you're just starting a YouTube channel and you're like, I want a vlog, brilliant. This camera's for you. Personally, I think it's for you. I think you should go for it. Great for vlogging. If you're a wee bit uncomfortable vlogging in public, this thing is not as noticeable as a big camera with big lens on it and stuff like that. You can get a wee microphone or a wee wireless Rode mic like I'm using the now. You can't even see it. And the thing is, if you've got a smaller setup, that's the difference between you maybe finishing a video. So you maybe thinking, oh, I'm too shy, there's too many people about, and then you end up not finishing the video at all, and then it just gets scrap. So this could, if you are kind of like that and you're kind of awkward in public spaces, well, once we can go into public spaces again after COVID, if it will ever end. Once you're in these public spaces, you might not want to vlog with a camera that's pure big and it's got one of these big microphones and stuff like that. This will be perfect. This is what you're looking for, and it takes great photos. It takes 24 megapixels. It's a great camera, great for photography. I would recommend it. Like I said earlier, the only way I wouldn't recommend it is if you've already got the M50. If you've not got any camera and you've got a really cheap camera at the moment, I just mean not as good quality. Yeah, totally. Upgrade to the M50 Mark II rather than the M50, 100%. I'll be putting out quite a few videos on the M50 Mark II just to see how far I can actually push it. I want to push this thing to its limits. I want to see what I can actually get out of this M50 Mark II. So if you're getting one, please consider subscribing to the channel. It would mean a lot. I'm just going to go over some basic things with this camera to take your photo and video to that next level. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.